Hey guys, what's up? Welcome to Linux Temple. And today in this video, I'm going to install the latest Ubuntu 21.04 on my external hard drive. And also you can apply the same method to install any version of Ubuntu on your external hard drive, USB drive, or in your internal hard drive. The process is basically the same. I'll tell you everything. And we'll start with a very basic thing. We'll start with creating a bootable USB drive with Ubuntu in it. And then we'll install Ubuntu on the external drive. And guys, if you are already familiar with creating a bootable USB drive, you can directly jump into the installation process also. You can see the timestamps below. And guys, there are lots of things that needs to be done after the installation of Ubuntu 21.04. And I've made a separate video on it. You can watch this video. The link is in the description. Okay, let's get into the topic. So here you can see I'm on Windows 10. So first I'm going to open the browser and then search for Ubuntu. Click on the first link. Okay, Ubuntu desktop. And there you can see two different versions of Ubuntu. Ubuntu 20.04, this is the LTS, long-term support release, with support up to 5 years until April 2025. And next one is the Ubuntu 21.04. And this is the latest release. And I'm going to download this ISO file. Just click on download. But since I have already downloaded this file, so I'm not going to download this again. And next, I'm going to download Rufus to make a bootable USB drive. So simply search for Rufus. Go to Rufus download. So you can just click in the first link. It's a very light software of around 1 MB. So here are the two files, Ubuntu ISO and Rufus. And now you need to insert a USB drive with minimum capacity of 8 GB. So here I have inserted the USB drive. And after that, you need to open Rufus. And first you have to select the device. You have to select the USB drive. So 16 GB USB drive. And then you need to select the ISO file, the Ubuntu ISO file. Just click and select. So there inside desktop, this folder. So here we have Ubuntu ISO. Just select this. And after this, just leave everything as it is. And as you click on the start, there you may see some pop-up window. Just click on OK, OK. And you'll get a warning that all the data will be deleted. Just click on OK. And then it will create a bootable USB drive. And this may take up to 5 minutes, depending upon the write speed of USB drive. And then you have to restart your computer. So here I'm using ASP laptop, and this is the USB drive with Ubuntu, and I'm going to install Ubuntu on this external hard drive. So as a power on, I'm going to press F9. Since this is the boot key, and there we have to select the USB drive. So there we have USB hard drive. Enter. Enter. So now Ubuntu is going to load from the USB drive. And there you can see two different options. Either you can try before installing Ubuntu, or you can directly install. But since we are going to install, so I'm not going to try this now. So simply click on install Ubuntu. So there you have to choose the keyboard layout and the language. And I'm leaving everything default. Continue. So there you can install the minimal or the normal version of Ubuntu. So I'm going to select normal, which includes all the required applications for our daily use. And also you can tick on install third party software for driver installation and other media codecs installation, and continue. So here you have to be very careful, since we are going to install Ubuntu on the external drive. So we are going to select this something else option. And continue. So here you can see the list of different disks and drives which are connected to your computer. So this first one, this is the USB drive, and second is DevSTA, this is the internal SSD, and the last there you can see, so this is the external drive, this is the external hard drive where I want to install Ubuntu. And there are already few partitions made, but I'm going to delete all those partitions. Just simply select the partition and then click on minus sign, and it will delete the selected partition. And now I have deleted all those partitions from the external hard drive. So there you can see all 500 GB of free space. So from here, I'm going to create some partitions. So for this, just select the free space and click on plus to create partition. So first I'm going to create a root partition. Of around 50 GB. And mount point root. Okay. And minimum 30 GB is required. Okay. And then you have to select device for bootloader installation. And this is also very important. Here you have to select the device where you are going to install Ubuntu, that is the external drive, this 500 GB external drive, and then click on install now. So it is warning us that the selected partitions will be deleted and formatted. Continue. So now you have to select your location. And then you can give your computer name and you can set password. So you can continue. And there you can see different slides regarding the best features of Ubuntu. And the installation process may take up to 10 to 15 minutes. So now I got a message that the installation is complete. So now I'm going to restart my computer. So here we have to remove the installation medium, that is the USB drive. So I'm simply going to remove this and then press enter. So now again, I'm going to enter into boot menu by simply pressing F9 so that I can boot my computer from the external USB drive. So there you can see Ubuntu. So it's going to load Ubuntu, and now you have to enter a password. So here's the welcome screen of Ubuntu. So it seems everything is working perfectly. So guys, in this way we can install the latest Ubuntu on the external hard drive. So I hope you find this video useful, and if so, please like this video and do subscribe our channel, and I always hope for your support. Thanks for watching. Have a nice time.